Good morning. This is WBRW Bridgewater. WBRW is owned and operated by the Bridgewater Broadcasting Company. WBRW is authorized by the Federal Communications Commission to operate on an assigned carrier frequency of 1170 kilocycles with 243 watts. And good morning, everyone. This is Greg Brobst here sitting in for Rick Adams. We are at Monday, November 3rd. Rick on vacation for the week. He's in Cancun, probably at the Taco Bell as we speak. It is a couple minutes after 7. We're going to welcome in for the first time Pat Harris with your news report. Good morning, Pat.
After a whirlwind tour of New York and New Jersey, President Clinton is concluding a two-day campaign push with an 11th-hour boost for the underdog Democratic candidate for governor in Virginia.
When I first saw this on the shelf at the thrift store, it looked like any other 1990s clock radio. Until I looked a little closer and noticed right on the front it says cassette clock radio. There were many cassette clock radios in the 1980s, and General Electric was one of the leading brands of them. But this one is definitely a lot newer than most of the ones you see. First of all, the overall styling has a very mid-1990s look to it. Every side is slightly curved. And one instant giveaway that it's at least from late 1993 is that the AM radio dial goes up to 1700, because that's when the FCC started requiring radio tuners to cover the new expanded band on AM. Previously, most radio tuners only went up to 1600 on the dial on AM. And then on the bottom we can look at the date code, and I've been told that with General Electric products, the second digit of the date code is the last digit of the year. So in this case, that means this was made in 1997. It's the model number 7-4925A. Made in China by Thompson Consumer Electronics. And it's not much bigger in overall size than many standard clock radios, such as this Panasonic Big Bell clock radio.
This old world, she's gonna turn around. Brand new bells will be ringing.
AM 1170 WBRW, Jonathan Edwards with Sunshine.
But in the top here, it has a cassette compartment where you can stick in any standard cassette, turn it on, hit play.
Garbage! Garbage!
Bag One says, "What's the latest with Melrose Place?"
And suddenly you're back in the 1990s.
Melrose Place is back. Hey. With a vengeance.
There is no way around me, Michael.
And the Queen of Mean.
I want you to stay away from my husband.
Amanda, that's enough.
Is badder than ever.
Now I can join Peter for a little moonlight swim.
Watch Amanda and watch your back on a brand new Melrose Place Monday.
So let's take a closer look at it. First of all, the cassette player. It's just a player. It does not record, although it does have rewind. Quite a few of these cassette clock radios basically used a cheap Walkman mechanism, so they only had fast forward, not rewind, but this one does. And that is a smoked plastic window through which you can kind of see the tape as it plays, although you need a very bright light shining directly on it in order to see through that window. There's a speaker. It's actually pretty good sounding for its size. It's only maybe 2.5 inches, but it has very good sound. It has dual alarms, which can be set to either music or a buzzer. And the music can either play the cassette or the radio. Buttons to turn on or off the radio, a sleep timer. Has a large snooze button, which also shows minutes and seconds if you hold it down. So you can see it's 7:46 right now, and if I hold it down, that shows the 6 of the 46 minutes and also the seconds. And notice it says snooze with the E, unlike General Electric's clock radios from the 1980s, which always left off the E on the end. Time setting controls are a little bit different than normal. Instead of hour and minute buttons, it has forward, fast forward, and reverse. and a switch on the side to either lock the time setting or allow you to set it. The clock display is larger than most clock radios, but a little bit unusual is that the indicator is for AM rather than PM, as indicators for the two alarms and aforementioned tuning dial. Over here, the volume control knob, AM and FM band selector switch, and the tuning dial. And on the bottom is the battery compartment for the 9-volt backup battery. So let's turn on the radio. This is actually 650 WSM from Nashville, Tennessee, which is about 700 miles away from me, picking it up via nighttime skywave. So this has a very good AM tuner.
Volume 1 and 2, 23 million. The Beatles' White Album, 24 million. Back in Black by AC/DC, 25 million albums sold. Hotel California by the Eagles, number 3 at 26 million. Michael Jackson with Thriller at 33 million.
Number 1, the greatest selling North American album of all time. I'll be shocked if you knew this, but applause to you if you did. We've already heard from them once. Number 1 on the list. The greatest hits 1971 to 1975 by the Eagles.
And leave a comment if you own every single one of those albums that that radio talk show host just mentioned. This is 900 CHML from Hamilton, Ontario. I can't play too much more of that because the Eagles are very, very strict about their copyrights on YouTube.
I did not expect that one to be number one on the list, but there you go. Number one all-time best-selling North American album. Get that one right? Good for you if you did. All right, your quiz question, your real quiz question. That was just a practice. Your real quiz question. On this day in 1869, the Suez Canal was completed.
So it has very good sound. It's just a little bit let down by the rattling of the plastic cabinet on certain frequencies at certain volume levels make it rattle. Otherwise, it sounds excellent. And that's just AM. Let's switch over to FM.
We only have them.
And now they want the money back. So you would figure, if anything, they should mail you $7 back.
Didn't look so good last night because the Vikings found a way to, do what they needed to do and take care of business.
There's a certain local representation of a New York accent on those two stations there.
I guess what we're saying is just don't sit and wait and say, well, I can't do anything until I turn 65.
Hey, Mike, you know what? You're 100% correct, but you know what? An issue that I meant to talk about in the last segment that came up this week.
A little too much reverb there. And one thing I noticed is that the clock display goes so close to the edge that unless you're looking at it almost straight on, you can't see the top of the digits, which is just one little annoyance about it.
Glaive is a 15-year-old singer from North Carolina, and he's been making music since he was 15. Yeah, he just started in April. Anyway, this is Glaive's new single. It's a quick and catchy piece of electropop called Eyesore.
Yeah, I'm sure that's going to be on the best albums of all time list in another couple years. At the beginning of the video, I showed using the alarm with a cassette to give the illusion of waking up to a radio broadcast from November 3rd, 1997.
See and test drive the 97 Cherokees, Wranglers and Grand Cherokees, ahead of their time and ahead of their class. Talk to your salesperson. They'll immediately give you the bottom line price that's always fair and competitive. Next thing you know, you and your Grand Cherokee will be traversing those mountain roads or those sand dunes at the shore. It all begins at Welsh's Motor Sales, 36 Dumont Road in Far Hills, the oldest Jeep dealership in New Jersey. They must be doing something right.
And the way that works is that if either the alarm or you turn on the power via this button here, it defaults to playing the radio, but if you stick in a cassette and put it in and hit play, it automatically switches over from the radio to the cassette. But if you turn the power off, You know, it also shuts off the power to the cassette motor. So if you have the alarm set, when the alarm comes on, it'll normally start playing the radio. But if you have a cassette inserted and push down the play button, when the alarm turns on, it'll start playing the cassette. Same thing with the sleep timer. It's playing the cassette. And if the cassette finishes before the sleep timer finishes, it switches over to the radio. And you can also use the snooze function of the cassette just as you would with the radio or the buzzer. But one unusual thing about the snooze is that it only lasts for 7 minutes instead of the typical 9 minutes. I thought the 9 minute snooze was an industry standard, but I guess not. And that's the sound of the beeper alarm. It is adjustable via the volume control. So that's about it for the cassette clock radio, because if you're a subscriber to this channel, and you probably are because lately YouTube has not been sharing my videos outside of my subscriber base, you know what a cassette player is and you know what a clock radio is, and this is just a combination of the two. The only really surprising thing is how new it is, because by 1997, I'm pretty sure there were already CD clock radios on the market, so it's unusual to see one of these from the late 90s.
That's Vince Giordano and the Nighthawks and the Cotton Club Stomp. Name of that piece from an album called Cotton Club Revisited.
Show. Here's a taste of what you've been missing. You've also been missing a little bit of this.
Hi-ho! Hello, hello, hello!
And don't forget about this.
As you can tell, there's a lot happening weekday mornings on 1170 WBRW.
Real people, real music, real radio.
I think that pretty much sums it up. It's Brian Thompson. I'm getting ready to get out of here. I got a train coming by. It means it's, boom, time to go. I'm out of here. I just want to thank you for tuning in today at AM 1170 WBRW. You can catch me next week, as I said before, from on Saturday, let's see, from 10 to 2, and on Sunday, of course, from 3 to sign off. For everybody here at AM 1170 WBRW, this concludes our broadcast day. Thank you for listening.
WBRW, Bridgewater.